For the last couple of years, the Art Gallery of Algoma has been proud to partner with the Indigenous Friendship Centre and Ontario Culture Days to present Indigenous ribbon shirts and skirts. In 2020, the AGA is presenting the tradition of these beautiful creations digitally, once again in partnership with the Ontario Culture Days and the Indigenous Friendship Centre. Featuring a variety of participants, ribbon shirts and skirts were photographed with works from the Art Gallery of Algoma's permanent collection by renowned Indigenous artist Norval Morisseau. We present Kathy Surrett, Executive Director of the Indigenous Friendship Center, and Dallas Abitong, Urban Indigenous Early On Cultural Coordinator, to talk about the history of the shirts and skirts and the importance of this event to the community.
Bonjour, Anin. Sonki Gabawi Kwaini Indishinakaz. Mayingando dem. Obajunang Ishkunagan Nin Donjiba. Anishinabe Ikwe. Nijomadewiani Kwaindao. So that was a traditional Ojibwe protocol greeting, and I said my Anishinaabe name is Woman Standing Strong. I am from the Wolf Clan. I belong to the Batchewana First Nation, and I'm also second degree in Armadewin Lodge. Good morning. My English name is Kathy Surrett. I am the Executive Director at the Indigenous Friendship Center in Sault Ste. Marie. And I'm just happy to be a part of the Culture Day again this year within the city of Sault Ste. Marie, and as well as participating in the Ontario Committee. This Culture Day, we are talking and showcasing our ribbon skirts and also our men's ribbon shirts. So the significance of the ribbon skirt is, first of all, I would like to say that it holds a lot of respect when we wear our dresses, our ribbon skirts. And it wasn't until around the 1800s when cloth was introduced to our tribes and our nations, our Indigenous nations. And a lot of our Anishinaabe people are really artists and crafters, and began to do and learn applique on the cloth, with the cloth. When we decide to make our ribbon skirts, whether they be for ourselves, for our daughters, for our granddaughters, we usually like to keep in mind our designs that depict the nation that we come from. So for instance, I am from the Anishinaabe Nation, which is part of our woodland tribes. And when we do our designs, I like to keep the woodland floral designs in mind, because that depicts the nation that you come from. And it's the same with the men's ribbon shirts as well. So each shirt and each skirt that is made is very personal. We can depict what is important to us as Anishinaabe people.
Bonjour, Jabwewe Anandishnakaz, Makwando Dame, Ojibwe Anishinaabe Kweyendao, Gaye Nuijomade Kweyendao, Skamakandonjaba, Bawatangdira. So hello everybody, my name is Dallas. My Anishinaabe name is Jabwewean, which means the one that pierces through. I originally come from Sagmuk First Nation, but I now reside here in Bawating, which is Sault Ste. Marie. There's a women's teaching behind that, why us women wear the skirts. And the gist of it is that we wear them because we are connected to Nimama Aki, so Mother Earth. Who we come from. We also dress up our ribbon skirts as well. That also goes for the men's shirt designs. The men wear them, wear the shirts, and they, you know, dress them up for spirit. With spirit, when we go into ceremony, we want to show spirit that, you know, we're coming to spirit in our best outfits, in our best bead work, quill work, whatever else that we have within our bundles that we want to show spirit, you know, that we're thankful for these gifts that have been given to us. So with my beaded mask, I have strawberries and floral on it. And that there, it signifies a part of my life and who I am as an Anishinaabekwe. How that ties into like a rites of passage when a girl becomes a woman. So that signifies that stage that I have gone through and how much I cherish that part of my life. Now for my moccasins, it's more contemporary because it has like luster beads and it has steel tacks in them. But with my moccasins, it's still floral, woodland floral, because that I wanted it to signify that I came from here. I came from this area. This is like a woodland area. Having our photo shoot within there, within that studio, it gives us a sense of pride too, because one of our people is a well-renowned artist. With some of the ribbon shirts and some of the ribbon skirts that came through, some of the bead work, some of the applique work, it complemented the work. So the artwork complemented the ribbon shirts and ribbon skirts, but it also, like, our colors complemented the artwork as well. The importance of having our community here in Bawating be a part of Culture Days, it's important because we want to help people understand that, you know, these ribbon skirts mean something to us. These ribbon shirts mean something to the men too. And to use this as a teachable moment to let people know, like, we are here, we are Indigenous. If you have any questions, it's okay to ask. It's okay to ask.